our session for the day. So that means we are 10 minutes late, and we may go, we may have additional 10 minutes before we conclude today. So bear with us. Again, I think for the people who have just joined, again, welcome to today's training. The training will focus on the technical aspect of installing the key population systems specifically, but generally we are going to see, we are going to learn how to install Kenya EMR because the key population module is hosted within Kenya EMR. So once you know how to install Kenya EMR, you will have the key population system already packaged together with Kenya EMR for you. Okay, so before we begin, maybe just to ensure that we have accurate list of our partners who are attending this training, I'd ask the guys who joined earlier to just self-introduce and tell us who they are and the organization that they represent. I guess that can continue, but maybe just a confirmation. I just want to be sure that I have the list of partners that we are going to train today. So just a confirmation from the list of the attendees, there are guys from KRC, there are guys from MEWA, I'm seeing somebody from AMPA, MEICO, Hope Worldwide, LVCT Steps, LVCT Daraja, and EGPAV. So if there could be any person, any other person that maybe comes from whose organization I've not mentioned, kindly you can just speak up or you introduce yourself in the chat section so that we have full account of all the partners represented here. Okay, so before we begin, I think I'll share with you a bit of what we are likely to cover today. I'm going to share my screen. Can anyone confirm if my screen is visible?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, thank you. So we are going to focus on four specific areas as shown on the Word document. So as I've said, we are going to do Kenya EMR installation. And by extension, that will give us a key population module. Then we are also going to see how to install the interoperability layer, which help us to kind of communicate across different system platforms and also help us in automatically uploading data or uploading reports to the DHIS2 platform. So that we might see tomorrow. Today we are going to focus basically on Kenya EMR installation. So I hope you have your laptops and you have your virtual box. If you looked at the agenda which I shared about early last week, we have various links where you are supposed to obtain all those resources. The virtual box, there's a link there. Kenya EMR package, there is a link. Ubuntu desktop 16.04, there is a download link. So I believe up by now you have those packages ready so that when we begin, we just do it together. Then we had a set of SOPs. We had a set of SOPs, which also are shared with you on the agenda. So if you look at the bottom of that particular document, we have the SOP of how to install Kenya EMR. and all the dependencies, including the IL and the AIR. So if you refer to that particular document, you'll be able to be very ready for this particular training. That is how I hope that you manage to install or you manage to download those and you have them ready for our use today. Okay. Little housekeeping for the day. If you have any question during the any of the sessions, feel free to ask the questions in the chat window. We have a team who will be checking in to be sure that your questions are responded to adequately. We'll also, because this is going to be a virtual technical training, we'll, whenever you are stuck, we'll advise you to reach out to us through the chat window. Let us know if you have a problem. And if you do, we'll be able to assist you through TeamViewer or through AnyDesk. So if you don't have any of those applications on the sites, you might want to just download and install TeamViewer or AnyDesk application. So that if you have a problem or you're stuck, you just share with us your TeamViewer ID or AnyDesk ID. Then any of our team members will be able to log into your machine and help you troubleshoot any of your problems. So then all of us will continue together. So I hope that is clear. A reminder, the call is being recorded for future use. So if you want to kind of go through this particular training, maybe tomorrow or any other day, we are going to record it for you so that we post it on our official project YouTube channel, where you can be able to just go there and replay the training. So we were supposed to have Shem or Kyoko open for us this session, but Shem has called to say they're a bit committed right now, they're on the road. So they have given us their blessings to continue with the training. So we might not have Shem or Kyoko joining us for today's session. Okay. Yeah, so I think up to that point, we are aligned, so we can just start our session unless there is any burning concern. So the training is going to be facilitated by Palladium, Kenya HMS project. We have a team of facilitators who will be taking different topics to take you through. So get your laptop ready, check your internet if it is strong enough, and let's start the training.
Hey, Bennett. Hello.
Yes, Ubuntu.
In addition to the resources that are there to download, I've added a link for the participants to download an empty OpenMRS DB on the chat.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I think if you check, let me just repaste this. Yeah, we are going to use a blank Kenya IMR database during our installation. So kindly download it and have it ready. When the time comes, you'll be shown how to use that database. So I think we'll start just by giving you a background on Kenya IMR. For the people who are here in Kenya IMR for the first time, you may be wondering what kind of a beast this is. So I just want to spend a few minutes to take you through the background of Kenya IMR before we get into the actual process of installation. So you'll allow me to share my screen. Thank you. confirm that you're able to see the screen. Can anyone confirm?
We can see it.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, so we are going to look at the technical introduction to Kenya EMR. We are going to look at what Kenya EMR is and what architecture does it run on? What are some of the architectural components? How does the data model look like? And we are going to have like a view of OpenMRS implementation distributions across the globe, and then the navigation. So just for a brief background, Kenya EMR actually runs on OpenMRS. So if you are working with Ampath, I'm sure, or you're working with Faces, I'm sure you've interacted with OpenMRS, okay? So OpenMRS is the base on which Kenya EMR is being built. So if you look at it, Kenya EMR becomes a module on top of OpenMRS. So when we are talking about OpenMRS as a system, this is an open source system. It runs on open source code base. That means it is open, transparent, and free. You can pick it, change the code, adopt it, do everything you want to do with it, everything as free as in free lunch. So that makes it easier or better in terms of maintenance. That means we can have collaborations across various system developers or experts who can contribute code to make it better or to improve on it. So it is a web-based system. And here when we talk about a web-based system, we are talking about a system that runs on a web browser. It can run on your Google Chrome, it can run on your Internet Explorer, or I think the popular one is Mozilla Firefox. So it can run on those. So that makes it a web application. And if you look at it, the way the variables are defined, the variables are modeled around something called the concept dictionary, which means that we are storing some of the commonly used concept or commonly used names, be it a name of a drug, name of a disease, or any other name or a variable that we'd like to store. They're already listed within the system in a database. And that is what we call the concept dictionary base. So in terms of design, OpenMRS has core system or core module, and then it has got other sub-modules or plugins. So this kind of help in expandability, that means you can come up with your own module, you can write a code, build your own module, and plug it into OpenMRS, as long as you adhere to the standards of how to build your applications on OpenMRS framework, then your system can work, your module can be packaged and work within OpenMRS. So it is extensively expandable. You can do so many other things with it. And it is programmed using largely Java, which runs on the Spring and Hibernate frameworks. And some of the web technologies that it employs are the JSP, HTML, CSS, and all the rest, which I might not mention all of them, but those are some of the technologies that it uses. So for a developer who has skills on those, can always extend the functionalities of Kenya EMR or of OpenMRS. So how does the architecture look like? The architecture of OpenMRS, and when I'm talking about OpenMRS, I want you to visualize Kenya EMR. I earlier said that Kenya EMR is built on OpenMRS. So that's why I'm talking about OpenMRS or Kenya EMR interchangeably. But in our context, in this case, it means relatively the same thing. So the architecture is a three-tier architecture, where we have the bottommost layer being the data access layer. For those who have experience in systems, you know about the access layer or the database layer. Then the middle transactional layer, where we have the service layer, and what the user see or what the user interact with mostly is the presentation layer. So this has been done to isolate various components for the ease of maintainability and also in terms of ease of system development, so that if I'm so experienced in modeling or designing the database, I focus my skills on the data access layer. If I'm so good in the REST APIs and also working with the APIs, I can focus my attention to service layer. And if I'm good at display or on the interface design, I can focus my attention to the presentation layer. Okay. So in a diagrammatic form, that is how the layers are arranged. So you'll realize that we have so many modules, and those modules also can, they have parts that are facing the interface and some that are working within the service layer. And some of those technologies that are being used at each layer, but the database largely uses MySQL or MySQL if you want. And the service layer, most of the time, it uses the OpenMRS API and REST. Though there is a new API technology that comes up, it's called the FHIR or FHIR, which is also being utilized at the service layer. The presentation layer predominantly uses the HTML and AngularJS. And I think there are other technologies that have been coming up, which are being utilized. So in terms of data modeling, OpenMRS employs the EAV model, entity attribute value data model. That is how the database is designed, which again, you'll realize if you have the experience or in future, if you are interested, you'll realize that it tends to store some of the variables or some of the data vertically as opposed to horizontally in some of the standard relational databases. So I don't want to go very deeply into the data model for our safety and comfort. We'll just have, I think, an idea on how the databases are interlinked in terms of relationships. And sorry, my image is not very clear, but I think it gives you an idea on how interconnected or how the relationships are working in the back end, in the database section. And finally, we look at the global OpenMRS implementation. Where else do we see OpenMRS implemented across the globe? So you can see parts of Asia, parts of the US, and largely in Africa, where they have intensively implemented OpenMRS. So in Kenya as well, we have implemented OpenMRS, and in this case, we have implemented it in the flavor of Kenya EMR. That's what we call it in Kenya. We call it Kenya EMR, but in the back end, it is OpenMRS. You can learn more about OpenMRS if you go to that particular link. But now I think to go specifically to Kenya EMR, we look at Kenya EMR, which I had said previously that it is a customization of OpenMRS to give it a Kenyan look, to make it fit into our local use case as Kenyans. So it has been built in compliance with the Ministry of Health EMR standards and guideline, which is a document you can always Google. It is in the NASCOP's website. You can Google that document and read about the standards and guideline that makes a system fit to be called an EMR in Kenya. The development originally, it was developed by an organization called ITEC, but then right now it is being supported and improved by us, Palladium, under Kenya HMS project. And it's a system that has evolved over time and it continuously evolves. every time there is a request for maintenance or any new feature, we will always go in and improve on the system and bring out new releases. So right now, I think the current release that we have out there is version 17.2.1, which again, you can always download for free. And I think from the link I shared, or if you wish, you could get it from the GitHub on the internet. So our version of Kenya EMR runs on Ubuntu platform. So I think in terms of operating system, the most popular ones that we know, we have Windows, Microsoft Windows as an operating system. We also have Ubuntu as a, which runs on the Linux framework as an operating system. So Kenya EMR works on Ubuntu platform. So that means you'll have to get Ubuntu installed on your machine before you attempt to install Kenya EMR. And we are going to see how that is done in the next few minutes. So Kenya EMR by implementation, it supports both point of care and retrospective data entry use cases. So if a facility would wish to have Kenya EMR just for reporting, they can use it for documenting the encounter and patient details after the patient is seen. So that is the retrospective use case. Or they may use it real time as they see patients. And in some cases, they can replace paper so that they don't have to use paper anymore. They rely fully on Kenya EMR to see their patients, do their reports, and do everything else that they want to do. That is point of care implementation. So the system supports both of those use cases. So it's upon the facility based on their preferences and their capability to implement Kenya EMR as they wish. And some of the program areas covered by Kenya EMR are listed as HTS, HIV, TB care, PMPCT, key population, PrEP, and more. So when you go into Kenya EMR, you realize that there are so many other program areas that are covered. And some of the key features that are included in Kenya EMR includes the integrated reporting, both for program and also for the Ministry of Health, including the donor reports. It also has full clinical order entry, for both pharmacy and laboratory. That means a clinician can order for lab tests without necessarily writing any paper. They can prescribe directly into the system without writing any paper, and the system supports that. Features like mother-baby pair are available, partner listing, especially for the contact tree and all those other features are available. And we have interoperability supported within the system. I'd already explained the interoperability layer, which I think we'll explain more tomorrow when we are installing it into the system. And also another feature called the PSMART feature, which again is also available on Kenya EMR. So in summary, that is how Kenya EMR looks like. And that's the end of my presentation, unless there is any questions before we start the practical installation of the system. So maybe you may raise up your hand. There is an icon for raising up your hand, or you can just type it on the chat window, so then we might we can be able to respond. So I'll give maybe a minute or two for questions and answers on the technical background of OpenMRS and Kenya EMR. So the first question is whether EMR can run on Ubuntu 20, Ubuntu version 2.0, the answer is yes and no. Yes is that by design it runs on Ubuntu regardless of the version, but there are some dependencies that the EMR relies upon that are not supported on higher versions of Ubuntu. So they'll be supported in future, but currently they are not supported. For instance, we'll talk about Tomcat. Right now we are using Tomcat 6 as a dependency for Kenya EMR. And this Tomcat 6 is supported right now, the version we're using, which is version 6, is only supported on Ubuntu 16 maximum. So if you move to Ubuntu 17 and 18, it supports Tomcat 7. So we haven't yet gotten to Tomcat 7 as it is. So that's why currently the highest version that we are supporting right now of Ubuntu is Ubuntu 16.04. But in the near future, we'll also upgrade some of those dependencies so then we can support Ubuntu 2.0 or above. Kindly share with us the EMR blank database. I think that has already been done. Yeah, so I don't see any other question on the chat area. But feel free to keep on asking. We'll be able to respond in real time as the training continues. So at this point, I think I'll pass the baton to my colleague, Dennis, who will be taking us through how to install Ubuntu 6.0. After that, we are going to have my other colleague, Kennedy Ugutu, who is going to take us through how to install Kenya EMR on Ubuntu. So I think at this point, let me pass the baton over to Dennis to take it up. Kindly note that we are going to use VirtualBox to simulate the training. So you don't really have to format your laptop to do this. You can use VirtualBox to just simulate your operating system and install Ubuntu safely on your virtual machine. I hope you've already downloaded those. So I think we'll just get started. So take it over, Dennis. Thank you. Oh, Dennis, we can't hear you.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
No, not very clear.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, if you try louder, maybe you can hear it.
Can anyone hear me?
No, your network is breaking. I don't know if you can reconnect.
Can you hear me?
It could be your man. It could be your microphone. Just try again.
Ubuntu, can you confirm now?
We can hear you, Dennis.
Hey.
We can hear you.
Then can you hear me?
Yes, we can. Yes,
we can hear you.
Hello?
Yes, yes.
Sorry for that. So let me, I'll be taking you through an installation of Ubuntu. So allow me to share my screen. So I'll be using VM for this one. So immediately you install VM, it will land you on this page. Don't worry about the Ubuntu server. But when you install VM, you should be landing on this page. I believe all of us are on this page. So for you to install Ubuntu, you just click on New. You select the name of the operating system. For my instance, let me call it Kenya EMR. You select the operating system. For our case, we will be using Linux. And it's also important to select the version. So I'll be using Ubuntu 64-bit. Nothing much on there, so you just click on Next. So here we are going to assign the RAM where the virtual box will be using. So for me, I'll just give it 2 GB. Then you click on Next. Don't click here, we'll be using create the virtual hard disk. Just create it. Just leave it as it is. Select on dynamically allocated. So here we are going to assign the virtual box, the hard disk. So for my instance, I'll leave it at 10 GB. It depends with the specs of your machine. So you can give it 10 or less. Then up to there we've done the configuration of the VM to the hard disk. So now it's now to go and pick the ISO file and install Ubuntu. So you come here, it's Kenya EMR. So you click on Start. So here you are going to select the ISO file. I believe all of us downloaded the ISO file. So for my case, I'll just be, you click on here to locate the ISO file. So for my instance, I'll be installing Ubuntu desktop version 16.0. So I just click on OK and Start. At this point, it's now launching the Ubuntu for installation.
Then you kindly check if you are sharing the right screen. I think this is a different screen from what you might be having online.
Okay. Can you see my screen? Can anyone confirm?
Dennis, the screen you are sharing is not the right one.
Let me just share again. Okay. So from here, we are going now to install Ubuntu. You just leave it on English, then select. So for now, we are not going to install the updates for the purpose of time, because updates makes the installation slower. So, but we will install them later. So for now, don't check on any, we just continue. Select erase disk and install Ubuntu now. Just continue. So this process does not require internet. So as long as you've downloaded the ISO file, you are free and well to go. So you come and select the location. So somewhere. Leave it on English, then we go ahead to continue the installation. Here we're going to assign the name to the machine. So mine, I'll just call it test. Then just to note, when you click the name, it normally comes with this extension. So for our case, we're going to delete it because we want the account name to be the same name with the host name. So if you don't change, your host name will be different. So just make sure it's on the same name. Give it a password. Confirm your password. Then continue to installation. So at this point now, we are installing Ubuntu. There's nothing much you can do here. So it's just to wait for the installation to complete and go on to login.
Yeah, so I think as this installs, just a reminder for the guys who have just joined to kindly self-introduce in the chat window so then we know you are here as we wait for the installation to complete. So I think as most of you have noticed is that installation of Ubuntu is very straightforward. Much of it is about clicking next all the way and maybe specifying a few things here and there, but it is as easy as what you've seen. So then it should not be a big headache. And again, I think one thing that we need to realize is that this, for the purposes of illustration for this training, we are using a VirtualBox environment, but in your implementation, you'll just do a bare metal installation directly on your server, be it a desktop machine or a real server, just direct installation on the machine. You don't need to use a virtual box. So I just needed to clarify that. In your own implementation at the facility, don't use virtual box. Install it straight on your machine. We are just using the VirtualBox for demonstration purposes because we don't want to format our laptops as we show you how to install KenyaEMR. So it's just good to note. When you do your installation also, it's good to be on the internet so that you get the latest files for your operating system. Ubuntu works best when it is up to date. So as you can see, it is downloading language packs. It is downloading a lot of other packs, packages from the internet so that it updates itself as it installs on your environment. So also as we wait, I don't know if there is anyone else who has done this with us because we thought we would do this together. So I want to believe that you are also doing it on your end. Even as we are going to have it recorded. So I don't know if there is anyone who is doing this, maybe by a show of hand. Or we don't have a hand icon on your end. Thanks, Owuko. Yours is done. Yes, Ruben, for your question, the migration package is actually on the GitHub. I don't know if Pamela from Ampath wanted to say something. So, Ruben, even as you get the migration package, please, before you migrate, you might want to reach out to your partner just to kind of understand the category of your facility before you migrate, just to be sure that all your data is going to be migrated and all your modules will be existing in the new platform. So before you use the package for migration, you may want to reach out so that you are advised accordingly. So over to you, Dennis.
Okay, so at this point, the installation has been completed. So we have to restart the machine for the effect to take place. So let's just click on restart. Up to that point, the installation has been completed. So you just log in the password that you had set earlier. So up to that point, the setup, the installation, Ubuntu installation has been completed. So that's how to go about it. Over to you, Putin.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dennis, for that. So what you're seeing on your screen is how Ubuntu desktop looks like after installation. You can do further customization if you wish to see it a different color than what you're seeing. Definitely it's a very stable platform to use and more secure. So I think that is what you need before you start installing KenyaEMAD. So I think the next one is going to be the how do we install KenyaEMAD on Ubuntu? So Kenny Dogut is going to take us on that. I don't know if there is any question before we transition to KenyaEMAD installation. Feel free to unmute your mic and ask. Okay, so I'll assume that there's no more question at this point. So I'll just request Ubuntu to take it away. Welcome, Kenny. Ubuntu, if you are talking, then you are muted. We can't hear you. We still can't hear you, Ubuntu. Yeah, so as we wait for Ubuntu to resolve his mic, I don't know if there is any question. Ramadan Said, I don't know if it is not very clear what you are asking, but you can make a bootable media from an ISO file that you download directly from the internet. You don't need to do it from the VM. Again, what we have done that I think might make this process a little bit easier is that we have tried to clone the whole process so that you simply run a clone of the KenyaEMAD and it installs for you the operating system plus all the applications that are required for KenyaEMAD. So we would share the process of that tomorrow, how to install KenyaEMAD using the clone. It is very easy. It only takes about 5 minutes. but we felt like you needed to know the standards procedure for Kenya Imari installation before we show you the shortcut. So we'll be showing you the shortcut tomorrow at I think between 3 and 4 tomorrow. So be available tomorrow to see how we do that. Ubuntu, I don't know if you have sorted it out.
Is it working now?
Yes, it is.
Correct.
All right, take it away.
Okay, thank you so much, Bernard, and apologies for the hiccup. Just had an issue with my mic. After the installation of Ubuntu, that is Linux, now we'll move on to the Kenya Imari installation. Allow me to share my screen. Are you able to see my screen? Are you able to see my screen? Yeah.
Yes, we can.
Yeah. Thank you. I just need to be sure. From the email sent out and the reference material that we were supposed to download, I hope everyone has got a copy of the same. And as you can see, that's my desktop, just the same desktop as Dennis took us through the installation of Ubuntu. So we are supposed to have the installation package for Kenya Imari, and then we need the guide and then the empty database. I just shared a link for participants to download the same. I hope all of us have the same. So if you have, then there we go. On my screen, as you can see, I have my installation package, that is Kenya Imari 17.10. I have my blank Open MRS database. So the package has got all the required files and directories. If you open inside, we have the dictionary, we have modules directory, Mozima forms, web apps. And we have the file that is the setup script.sh. So these are the contents of the installation folder. So from the SOP, for us to run and install Kenya Imari successfully, we first need to install the dependencies. If you have your SOP, we have three dependencies. That is Java 7, Tomcat 6, and MySQL 5.6. So you have to ensure that the correct version is installed. If you don't install the correct version, either you install Java 8 or any other version apart from Java 6, your installation might not be able to complete and run successfully. So ensure you follow the SOP to the latter for you to have the outcome that you need. So for us to install, for us to install the dependencies, we'll start with Java. And remember, all this we'll be doing on the terminal. For you to open terminal, you can always go to search and then type terminal. That is one way of opening the terminal. If you click on it, it loads for you the terminal. So this black screen is what we call the terminal. If anyone calls you and tells you kindly open the terminal, that is one of the ways of opening the terminal, or you can use a combination of keyboard keys, that is Control, Alt, and T will open for you the terminal. So all the commands that we're going to run, we're going to run them on this particular terminal. So according to SOP, I hope everyone has a copy. We'll be going step by step, start by installing Java. So to install Java, we run this particular command. It's always advisable if you have the SOP, you just copy and paste to avoid missing out on something or errors while typing. So I will paste my command to install Java 7. So first we'll have to install the repository. We add the repository, you enter the password. Remember the password you created while installing Ubuntu is the password that you'll be expected to enter in this particular session. So after adding the repositories, then we'll update the system, the repositories that we've added. So to update the system, we'll run this particular code, that is sudo apt-get update. So what you need to know is that for you to install the dependencies, you must be connected to the internet.
Christy, in my available.
Someone is coming in the petty cash. Kindly, can someone help us with the affected person?
Mama, niwe na mimi ya weekend poko cha kuduka.
Then I'll help us unmute this person, to mute this person, please. Okay, after updating the package, then we'll run the script to install Java 7. So, that is the script that will help us in installing Java 7. So we'll just run that. And then when asked if you want to continue, I say yes by typing Y, and then I press enter.
But in any manner, can I get to give you see? We're not going to give you see.
So we are going to. So depending on the speed of the internet, yours might be running faster than mine or slower than mine. But for us to install the dependencies, that is the only time that we need internet connection. After installing the three dependencies, that is Java, Tomcat, and MySQL, then we'll not need internet. That's the only time we need internet while installing the dependencies. Almost done. Okay, so we have already installed Java. So we move to the next step of installing the next dependency, that is Tomcat 6. So to install that, you first add a repository the way we did for Java. We have added the repository, so we just update the system with the contents. To do that, we run the same script. So the contents of the repository will be incorporated in the system for us to install Tomcat. It's done, so we'll now go ahead and install Tomcat. So we do sudo apt-get install Tomcat 6. Kindly ensure when you're doing this, you specify, because otherwise you'll install the wrong one. So to continue, type yes, then you press enter for it to continue the installation. So we are done with that. We'll go ahead and install Tomcat 6 and main 2. We are done with the Tomcat 6 installation. We'll move ahead and now install MySQL. So so to install MySQL, we'll add a repository too. And then we update. Then we install MySQL 5.6. That's a script run to install MySQL 5.6. Continue, press Y, and continue. Okay, so in this particular window, we are expected to at least provide a password for the user root, which is very important. You need to take note of this particular password, because if you provide a password here and then forget it later, then you might not be able to successfully install Kenya EMR. So ensure that you take note of this particular password and you don't forget this password. Otherwise, if you do, then you'll get stuck, meaning that you'll have to uninstall and reinstall it again. So it's always very important to take note of the Linux password, that is Ubuntu password that you provided, and also MySQL password. Very important. So I'll provide a password for MySQL, and then I confirm by repeating the same for the installation to continue. Kindly take note of that particular password. Very important, because we'll need it in the course of KNMR installation. Okay, so we are done with the installation of the three dependencies, and what you need to take note of is that in Ubuntu 16, MySQL might not be able to automatically start when you restart your server or computer. So we'll run a script that will enable MySQL each and every time you restart your machine or you shut down your machine, when you power it on, then it starts automatically to avoid errors while opening KenyaMR due to MySQL not running. So we'll run that particular script to ensure that MySQL starts automatically on restart. So that is the script that we are going to run. So in Ubuntu 16, take note, you don't forget about this. Otherwise, each and every time you'll be starting your machine or server, you'll be starting it manually, which is not always ideal because it wastes a lot of time. After starting, you have to restart Tomcat, that also takes time. So it's very important not to pass that particular step. So up to that point, we have installed the dependencies, and what we are going to do next is to configure a Java heap setup file so that Java will have the necessary memory allocation to ensure that KenyaMR runs smoothly. So to do that, I think from the SOP, it's provided there, the default one that has already been provided in that particular SOP. So that is what we're going to use. So to do that, we'll do sudo edit just a minute, we did restart Tomcat after the installation. Let me just restart Tomcat sudo service. Restart. Okay, so Okay, so this is where we adjust the Tomcat. Keep memory. So you just copy the line that has been provided to this particular file. I hope everyone can see this line. Are you able to see this line that starts with Java ops? Any response from the team? Hello? Can you hear me? Okay, so we'll paste the line down here. This is the line that I've just picked from the SOP. I hope everyone is able to see the same. So after doing that, just save and close. So just to be sure that it has saved successfully, we're going to restart Tomcat. If Tomcat restarts without errors, then we are good to go. So we'll do sudo service Tomcat 6. Restart. So it comes back to prompt, then we are good to go. Very good. So that one, we are done with the first session, that is installing prerequisites and then configuring the Java heap setup file that we've just done now. Now to the next, let me just minimize my terminal. Next, we'll have to copy the necessary files into their respective directories to ensure that KineAMR runs the way it's supposed to be. So if you open the installation package, we have a directory called web apps. That directory, there's a file called OpenMRS profile. This is a very important file that will enable OpenMRS to run. Remember, KineAMR runs on OpenMRS, and this is the file that will.
Next.
Okay, so for ease of illustration, I will copy this file to home. And then copy to the respective directory. We'll copy it into the part of var, lib, and then Tomcat 6, and then we'll have the web apps directory. So we'll take it to that directory. And to do that, we'll go back to our terminal and we'll use the following script to copy the file to that particular directory. So we'll do sudo cp. Cp is copy in Linux. And then I will open mrs.war file. Now we'll provide the path to where we would want this particular file to be, where we are copying it to. So from here, we are copying it from the home directory to that directory that we provide the path for. So we'll provide the path. So we'll take it inside that particular directory for it to function the way it's supposed to be. So after doing that, we press enter, and that one means that it has gone successfully. Now we'll confirm by accessing the same directory and confirming whether the file is there or not. So to do that, we will do cd change directory var webapps. So I will lift the contents of the directory to see whether OpenMRS the profile was copied there. So as you can see, the file was copied successfully. And as you can see, it is in a red color, meaning that it is not accessible. So what we need to do is to provide the read, write, and execution rights to this particular file for it to function the way it's supposed to do. So for us to do that, we'll go back one step to provide the same rights to the directory hosting it and the contents that are in that particular directory. So to go back to one directory, down we do cd space and then two dots. We'll be back to Tomcat. So we'll use the following script to give rights to the directory, a web apps directory plus the OpenMRS WAR file. So it is sudo change mod, and the mod will change to all the contents of the directory. And to give all the access rights, we'll use this particular code 755 that will give all the necessary read, write, and executable rights to that particular directory, that is the web apps. So to confirm the same, we'll go back to the directory and confirm if the necessary rights have been given to the OpenMRS WAR file. So we change directory to web apps, and then we confirm that the same has been done. As you can see, OpenMRS WAR file has changed color to green, meaning that now it has the necessary read, write, and executable read, write, and executable rights. And as you can see, it's now changed color, meaning that we are good to go on that end. So the next we are going to copy the modules into Tomcat directory, and I will provide the path of the same. So we'll go back to root for ease of illustration. We'll cd to the directory where we want to create another directory where OpenMRS will be running from. It will be hosting the modules directory. So we'll cd to user, share, Tomcat 6. So inside Tomcat 6, we'll create a directory called .openmrs. And you kindly take note of the naming of the file so that you don't make any mistake, because it has been used in the course. If you make any mistake in terms of the naming, you might not be able to run OpenMRS successfully. So we will create a directory. We'll do sudo make directory. That directory is OpenMRS. Kindly take note of the naming of that particular directory. So for us to confirm that the directory is there, as you can see now, we have created that particular directory. So we will copy this particular directory, which is inside the installation package, to that particular directory that we have created. So for us to do that with ease, and for illustration purposes, we will copy these to home. And then we go back to root directory. We want to copy that particular directory, the module directory, inside the .openmrs directory that we just created. So to do that, we will do sudo cp. As you can see, the initial one, that when I was copying the openmrs.war file, I didn't use the dash r, I just used cd copy. So if you're copying a directory that is having content inside, you need to do it recursively so that the directory and the contents are copied. But if you're copying a file, just a single file, you don't need to do it recursively because it's just only that one file. So that is why. So we will provide the path to the directory where we want to take it to. Okay, so that is the path. Remember, we created the folder, the directory.openmrs inside Tomcat 6. So that is where we are copying the modules directory. So after that, you just press enter, meaning that it has gone successfully. Let's confirm if the contents are there. We'll access the directory. Let's confirm if the, yeah, the module is there. Let's confirm if that directory has got modules inside. We cd to the directory. And then as you can see, all the modules necessary or needed for NMR to run have already been copied inside the, inside here. And they are owned by root, which is not a good thing. They are supposed to be owned by Tomcat for them to function the way they are supposed to be. And also, they are supposed to be given the read-write right on the same. So for us to change the ownership of the modules and also to give the read-write and executable rights to the modules, we'll go back one step. And then now we execute the commands on the modules directory. So we will change ownership first. So we'll do sudo change ownership. And we'd want that to be done to all the contents, the directory and the contents to Tomcat 6. Okay. So we'd want to change the root. If you can see the owners now of the modules is root, we want that to change to Tomcat. So that will do to the modules directory. And then we give the read, write, and executable rights to the modules too. Okay, now we can cd to the module directory and confirm if the changes that we've done have been effected. So as you can see, even the colors changed. And also, if you look at the ownership has also changed from root to Tomcat 6. Are we together up to that point? Are we together? Am I Koswali?
Niendelea tu.
Okay. So after making the necessary changes, let's restart Tomcat. And then now we go and launch OpenMRS on our browser to continue the installation. So let me minimize my terminal and open the browser. So from here, do localhost 8080, if you press enter and you see that it works, it means that your Tomcat installed successfully. So the easiest way to know that your Tomcat is running and it's okay is by running this on your web browser. So this one shows that your Tomcat is running well. So we'll add OpenMRS and press enter. Then it will bring us to the installation wizard. So from the installation wizard, we move on by clicking the arrow that is just, I don't need to do anything. Yeah, you just click on this particular arrow. Sorry for the hiccup. I forgot to give the .openmrs the necessary rights, and it's supposed to be owned by Tomcat. That is the step that I missed. I hope you're okay. You can continue the installation. You don't need to change anything here. Just click on the arrow. And then here, now you'll provide, you remember when you are installing MySQL, we created a password. So that password is needed here, so that that's what I was telling you, that it's very important to take note of the password so that you don't forget it. So you provide the password and then you continue by clicking the next arrow. You don't need to change anything on this particular session. And then you click on the next arrow and then you give it time. it will create the necessary database, that is the OpenMRS database in MySQL, the user, that is the root user, and the password that you provided, the tables, and some other core data, and then update, after which we'll run our DB, the one that I shared a link for you to download. Just update the schemas with the latest one that KenyaMR is using. So we'll just give you time. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, kindly, as we wait for it, for this process to continue, you can ask any questions. Bernard.
You're so good to me.
You can have a small QA session as we wait for the process to finish.
Yeah, I think, I don't know if Kenina has a question.
Okay, Ken, my question was, what is the issue when we get that error that you are trying to solve and you are not talking? So we get sometimes that error and we need an explanation of how to solve it.
Okay, thank you, Kenina. I think I explained that, but I can still repeat. I didn't give rights and ownership to the directory.openmrs. I only gave it to modules directory. So the rights supposed to start from OpenMRS, including the directory that which is inside, that is modules directory that is containing all the modules. That is why that error came about. But after giving rights and changing the ownership of the directory.openmrs, that was resolved. As you can see from here, the directory OpenMRS is owned by Tomcat for my screen. Initially, it was still owned by root. I hope it's clear.
Yeah, I think that's clear. So just to add on to what Ken is saying, Ken, is that Linux or Ubuntu has got very strict authentication or access rights to its files. So you realize that I can give you right to a folder to open it, but you can't open the file inside that folder. So it goes, the security in Linux goes all the way to the individual files, so that you can even find that you have a right to a folder. You have the right to open a file, but you don't have the right to save that file or to edit it. So it is as strict as that. So that's why if you forget to give required right access rights to all the levels that are required, you'll find that you start getting some errors, especially when you're running KenyaMR. So like in that instance, Ken forgot to give ownership of the OpenMRS folder to Tomcat. So as much as Tomcat has access to that folder, but the fact that it is not owning it, it cannot access it. So that's why that we saw that red error that Ken was trying to resolve. So when you install KenyaMR, you'll be meeting some strange errors that maybe to you might seem strange. And that's why we have provided the service desk line, which is already on our chat screen. So then you can sometimes reach out if at all you encountered any issue. Our service desk team will be on standby to support and help you understand the error and also help you now to resolve it.
Thank you, Ben.
So I don't know if there is any other question or concern from anybody else. So again, just to remind you, what we have gone through is the standard process of KenyaMR installation. That is what it takes to install KenyaMR. But as I say, tomorrow, we are going to take you through a shortcut, which you may choose to use, or you may choose to go this direction of installing all these dependencies one by one. So I think after tomorrow, you'll be at a position to really make better decision on how you want to do your installations at the facility, whether you want to go the clone way, which is the shortcut, or the standard way, which we are showing you right now. But I think for your benefit, it will make a lot of sense to understand and learn how to do both, because when it comes to troubleshooting, if you use the standard approach, you'll be able to understand your errors and be in a better position to resolve them. But if you use the shortcut that we're going to show you tomorrow, it is easier to install, but when it comes to troubleshooting, you'll be shocked at what kind of errors you are getting. So it is good to have an idea of both, learn how to do it in a standard way, also learn how to do it in a shorter way. So I think we'll wait for the OpenMRS installation to complete. We are almost done. Once this is done, I think the next stage is just to use the blank database that we were using. Yeah, so as a reminder, I've also shared with you some SOPs. I've shared some link within the chat for SOPs on how to install Java, Tomcat, and MySQL as OpenMRS dependencies. And I've also shared the SOP on the process of installation. So I think those will be very important for you. You can always refer to those documents even as you do your installations. User bin dpkg returned an error. What kind of error? You may just copy and paste the error on the chat so then we can help. Ken?
So this particular process always depends on the machine specs. If you have higher specs, then it will take a shorter time. But patience is key for it to complete. If it doesn't complete successfully, then you may not be able to run Kenya EMR.
As we wait for that to complete, I think it's also good to remind everyone that OpenMRS uses a bit of resources on your machine. So when you're making decisions on your servers for the facilities, you may want to have, or you may want to procure servers with very good specifications so that you don't run into performance issues when after installing Kenya EMR, because if your machine doesn't have good specifications, then you're likely to really compromise on performance. It can be very frustratingly slow. So it's always good to have a minimum. We have a guiding document on the minimum specifications for a typical server at a facility. One is to have a server with at least, in terms of disk space, at least 500 GB disk space. In terms of memory, it should not be less than 8 GB memory. So that is good to have. And in terms of the processor clock speed, is supposed to be more than 3 point something. So if you have like 3.2, 3.3, all the way to 3.6 gigahertz, that will be a good performance for your server. So I felt it was good to just bring that to your attention, so that even as you think of installing Kenya EMR, you know that you need to have some minimum specifications. Otherwise, the performance will be so frustrating for the users and for your facilities. So that is just, that information is good to have anytime you want to decide on installing Kenya EMR. So I think the installation is almost done. I think I want to just remind the guys who came in during the session, and those who are yet to register, kindly register your name in the chat section. Just your name, your designation, and the partner you work with for our file. So if you haven't done that, kindly do it before the end of the training.
That question is almost done.
Oh, Ken, I don't know if you had mentioned this, but I think it's good to mention that for you to install all of the Kenya MRP dependencies, you need to be online. So every time you install Kenya EMR, you have to be online, especially if you're doing it on Ubuntu. There are no offline installers, so you have to be online and run all those installation commands as you are shown. So the internet is a must.
So as I said earlier, this particular session now will depend with the specs of the machine that you're using, that you're installing. If you have a machine that has got higher specs, then it will take a shorter time to run the installation wizard. And so the only thing that can do is to just exercise patience for it to complete. It's almost done. So I think the other bit to note here is also, even as we look at the screen, is that you may think that nothing is happening from the interface, but in the background, there is a lot that is happening. So the screen could be, there could be no activity shown on the interface, but in the background, it is doing some things. So once everything is done, it will give a load for us the next page, which could be the Kenya EMR page, or which could be another page that requires us to take further action. Yeah, so it's always just good to just give it time. Once it is done with all the preparatory processes, it gives us the next direction. So I think that's why Ken is asking us for patience as we wait for it to finish. Yes, hello. The wizard has just completed the processes that it's undertaking, and when it loads this particular page, you don't need to worry. It only means that we are currently running an outdated version of Concept Dictionary, and the easiest way to cure this particular error is to restore latest Concept Dictionary. So for us to do this, we are going to use a full database schema that has got all the necessary concepts, dictionary, and also has got the necessary database structure. So for us to do that, we'll go back to our terminal. And remember, that particular database, full database schema is the blank OpenMRS DB that I shared a link for you to download. So we are going to restore these in MySQL, OpenMRS database, and then we restart Tomcat and we'll be good to go. So for us to do that, let's go back to root and then log into MySQL. So for us to log into MySQL, we use the following script. I do MySQL minus u root n minus t. So for us to log into MySQL, it will ask the password, the same password I was telling you that you didn't need to take note of, the MySQL password I created. So I will enter the password I created for my MySQL, and there we go. So as you can see, I've already logged in to MySQL. So we just confirm the databases I have, and I would want to restore the database schema in the OpenMRS DB that was created by the wizard, the OpenMRS wizard. So I will use OpenMRS database, and then I source for the DB. So for me to restore the same, I will source, and the easiest way to do that, instead of providing the path that you might make mistake, is just click on the database, blank database provided, and you drag it to the terminal. When you drag it there, it creates for you the path, as you can see. So you remove the quotes, and then all the statements in MySQL end in a semicolon. Don't forget that, otherwise it won't run. So you remove the other quote. There we have our path to the database, the easiest way, and then you press enter for the query to run. So we are restoring the database, after which we are going to restart Tomcat and then refresh our browser and have our terminal run. So this one will take a shorter time to run. So when you're installing KenyaMR, after running the wizard, you get this particular page. Kindly, don't worry. You're only running an updated version of the Concept Dictionary. Just restore a database with the latest Concept Dictionaries and tables, and you'll be good to go. Fine. I've also provided a link to our YouTube channel on the chat, whereby you can get the video job aids, including the NEMAR installation, IL installation, and how to use the several products that we have. And so you can go to YouTube, search for Palladium Kinetic Maestro, you'll get the job aids there. Kindly don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel when you access it. So as you've just seen, apart from the at least the waiting time because of the specs of the machine I'm using, installation of NEMAR is not that difficult, not that technical, if you just follow the SOP and install the three prerequisites. That is the only time you need internet. And then you do the configuration in terms of having the files and directories in the respective directories, then it's not hard installing in the NEMAR. Is there any question or clarification that anyone wants as we wait for Tomcat to finish restarting? So as we wait, I would just like to inform the team that tomorrow's session, I will start at exactly 8 and will be ready as early as 1:30. You can start joining so that we start at exactly 2. The session will open at around 1:30, so kindly just organize and you'll be ready by that time so that at exactly 2 we are started, so that we finish early. Yes. Hello, everyone. As you can see, we have been able to successfully install KineUMR. And you just need now to log in using the default password. Let me just log in using this username admin123. Okay. Yes, there we are. So we have successfully installed KineUMR. As you can see, we used a blank database, so it doesn't have any data. And then if you want to know the version of KineUMR running for my screen, you can see next to KineUMR app here, what I've selected always. At times we call users and ask them which version of KineUMR they're using, but they're not able to get it. So that's where the version is written and the facility name, which you can always change the facility name depending on which facility you are working with. So I think up to that point, I am done and I'll take it back to Bernard. Thank you and have a good evening.
Yes, thank you, Guthrie, and thanks for taking us through this. I'm sure the participants are wondering where is the KP icon and where is the KP module? And also if you could show them how to change the facility name, because I'm sure they'll want to change the facility to reflect their facility. Yeah, so I think Guthrie, you can show us that.
Yes, hello.
Yeah, we can hear you. Ubuntu, are you there?
Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Okay, for you to change the facility name from the module that you're seeing here, you go to admin module. Under admin module, if you look at the tasks, we have manage accounts, manage report queue, and then redo first time setup. So we'll go to redo first time setup so that we set up the facility name. So this is the place where you select the name of your facility by clicking this down arrow key. You start typing the name of your facility. I don't know which one I can use. Let me use Lumumba Health Center. All the facilities within the country are available here. So what you need to do is just select your facility. So that you set up Lumumba Health Center. That is all you need to do. And then you click on Save Settings. So when you save the settings, as you can see, it has changed the name of the facility to Lumumba Health Center. Now, when you go back to home and check on the modules that are available, the version that we're running, that is version 17.1.0, is missing the KP module and that particular module is provided in the later version of PNAMR, that is version 17.21. So tomorrow we'll have a session whereby I will take you through on how to upgrade a system. So after the upgrade, then we'll be able to have the KP module that we will be using tomorrow. So the module is available. We can always incorporate it in this particular version. So it's just a module that's added to the modules folder. You remember the modules folder that we copied, just add that particular module and we'll be having the KP or any other module that you need, whether it is IL module or whether it's any other module that you want to add into your system. So that is why the KP module is missing among this particular module. So kindly plan to join the session early. The session will be open as from 1:30 and most probably by 2 should get started. So that is all from my end. Thank you. To you, Bernard.
Okay, thank you very much, Kuned. Yeah, so I think up to that point, we have seen how to install KDMR and we have seen the process. So I think I'll give maybe a couple of minutes. We are way past the allocated time, but I think I can allow 5 minutes of questions for the remaining participants before we call it a day. So if there is a question, just unmute and feel free to ask. Okay, silence means there is no question, and that means either everyone has understood and is satisfied, or the reverse could be true. Yes, David.
I wanted to confirm. The link to the YouTube channel, do you have all the tutorials on how to begin this process, because I was not in for the beginning of the training. Maybe I could go through those videos and get to catch up. That's all.
Yeah, yes, David, that is correct. If you go to YouTube channel, you'll find the video job aids for how to install the dependencies, how to install KNAMR. And above that, we are also going to upload this current video, the session we've had today, we are going to upload it on YouTube. So from tomorrow, you'll be able to access it on YouTube. So all that will be available on that on our channel. And don't forget to subscribe, so then you'll get reminded every time we upload new videos. Okay, I don't know if there's any other question. All right, yeah, so I think then our time is much spent. I think we are now having about 50% of the participants we started with. I think most of us might have dropped off along the way, which is understandable because of the difficulties of following a technical training virtually. But I think for the remaining guys who are here, I'm confident that you've kind of followed and you'll be able to follow the videos and even do this on your own. So for us, I think from our end, we just want to thank you for taking your time for the day one. We are going to have you again tomorrow, same time, but for tomorrow, I think we are requesting you to join in a little bit early so that we can start on time. Yeah, so otherwise, I think let's meet again tomorrow for IL setup and the air and also the shortcut. So thank you very much and have a blessed evening. Bye from us.